Okay, now members, let us see the vertical motions and what happens in vertical motions. What we've been seeing is horizontal motion, and here always the particle we have been considering that the particle is having a constant velocity in that case. But here, when we are in vertical motion, this is the vertical motion we are talking about. When we are in vertical motion, it means that now the speed is going to be varying. For example, when you get a ball and then you rotate a particle in there, as it moves around and up the ball, its velocity is going to be changing. So that the cases we are going to be having here. That is the case, it means that even the acceleration is going to be varying. And so there, we are always going to use apply the principle of conservation of energy. But before we see that, let us see the main types of vertical motion. We have basically two. When the particle is kept, when the particle is kept in a circular path, and when it cannot be in a circular path. So here, the particle can't leave a circular path. For example, when I have this circular ring here, and I tie a particle here, and then I rotate it around, a particle can never leave if I tie it there strictly. So there, the particle can never leave. That's one of the cases. So this can happen in three ways. These are the three ways. But before we go back, let us consider this diagram here. If I have now here, you say that the velocity is going to change. So if it changes from U to now V, remember, if I have this from here up to here, it's the radius of the sun. So from here up to here, it's the same from here up to here. Now, if I can able to get this, so this is going to be, if I know this, then I can get this. This is R cos theta because it's adjacent to the angle. So if I want to get this distance, move from here up to here, it means that it's going to be, I get from here, then minus from here up to here, which is going to be equal to that. Using the third equation of motion, this one. But now here the particle, I think you can see it's going to be, that solution is going to be, you see, the particle is always falling. Okay, I think you see it's against, it goes against gravity. I think you see it goes against gravity first. So there, our V is going to be negative, and then our distance is going to be D. The distance move from there up to there. Okay, so if we put it there, then this is the case we are having there. Our cos, how we get into the cos is that this R is common. If we factorize it out, we have R into 1 minus cos theta. And if I get a square root of this, this is what I'm going to, because all, most of our things, we are going to base on this. Okay, then part A, the three ways are completes a circle. If now we are seeing when a particle can't leave a circular path. The first case is, it's going to complete a circle if V is greater than zero and the top of and U squared is greater or equal to 4R and D. Now, here if it's at the top, it means that now the angle, this angle has been, this is the case when we have, you see, from here it's down, but there it's at the top, when it reaches the top there. So the angle between this and this is going to be 180. Now, if the angle is 180 and I put here 180, so no cos of 180 is negative 1. So that's why here I have negative 1 from here. Because cos of 180 is negative 1. It's the second quadrant. And in the second quadrant, cos is negative. That's why I have negative 1 there. Now, if I simplify this and this, I get negative 2. I mean positive 2. This positive 2 times this will be RB for now. So I have 4B R as you see there. Now, because we are getting the square root of this, for this to be a real number, it means that what we have inside should be greater than 0, so we shouldn't have a negative. So it means that now the whole of this should be greater than 0, and this square should be equal to that. That's when we have that case there. Okay, so that's the case when it's at the top here, and the B is greater than 0, meaning it's still moving, but it's at the top, but it's still moving. So B is greater than 0, it's not just stopping. Okay, come at least at the top. If B is 0 at the top and U is equal to 4 G R. Now, if it's that the case, then it means that now, if it, you see that this B is equal to 0. So now here is coming and rests at the top. So meaning now the order of this, so to be at rest means that even this one here, we are not going to be having anything. So at rest. So meaning the order of this also
should be equal in 2, 0, meaning that this is going to be equal to that for it to be 0, as you see the case there. Also, if B is 0 for theta between 0 and the and what? And the 180 and B. Now you see, if this is going to be less than 0, means that we are going to be having complex number there. So the particle is just going to oscillate like that. So that's the case we are having there. Then the part B, now here is the particle can leave a circular path and becomes a projector. Now, I think you know projectiles. If I throw this chalk here, if I'm shimming, this is now assuming I'm rotating this particle here, then suddenly it leaves. You see, that's the case we are having. You're rotating something and then suddenly it leaves. So there it's creating a projectile. And when we have a projectile, these are the cases we are having. So, if a particle is on a string, so for example, if I have this particle, then I'm swinging it like this. Suddenly, when it's not tight enough, it's going to leave off and then it falls. But when it's leaving, it's going to be forming a projectile. A projectile, I think we saw projectiles a long time ago. So, it completes the circle if this were like 0 for all values of theta and this were like this. Now, where are we getting this from? At a equilibrium when the particle is moving, I think remember these equations. When we are dissolving, remember these equations. Now, when you simplify this and you put where there is V, you come and put this. Where there is D squared, you come and you put this. And then when you simplify, when you put where there is D squared, you put this, then you are going to get something like this. So our tension is equal to this. So if tension is equal to this, it means that now the whole of this shouldn't be a negative, it should be greater than 0. Now, if it's at this top, then if theta is 180, so we are going to be having a negative. So we have negative 1 minus this, so we have negative 3BR minus 2BR. That's when we shall get the 5BR in simple terms. So that should be greater or equal to 0. That is the case we are having there. So that's how we get the negative BR. When theta is 180, it implies that our U is going to be greater or equal to 5BR when you put it there. That's the case we are having. Becomes a projectile if this is 0. Now, as we are swinging like this, and the particle, you see that now the tension is there. Look at it, look around and swing. Then, when we don't have any tension now, look. I think we see what happens. When this is zero, when we have this rotation. This rotation means there's no any stretch in the string, so the string is just like this. So when it's zero, the particle, I think we've seen how it's falling off. You look properly. I think we see how it falls off. Let me do it like this. Look. I think we see. So that's the case when the motion is not going to be completed, so it can easily fall off in that corner. Okay. Also, if V is equal to 0, that's the idea that we saw so here in oscillating. Now, the next lesson we are going to see in summary is when we have the particle at the top and when we have the particle at the bottom, what happens? That's what we are going to be having in our next lesson. So that's it. I wish you well.